Last year, 2020, Pocketbook released the Pocketbook Color. It was the first e-reader ever using a color screen that was available internationally. There were a couple other iterations of e-ink devices, but they were primarily locked down Chinese ecosystems like WeChat and Baidu, and you couldn't even go to google.com even if you tried. The Pocketbook Color was a raging success, and many devices followed, putting in a grand total of 6 devices using e-ink Kaleido 1. This is the Pocketbook InkPad Color. This is based off of the Pocketbook InkPad, not the X, but the regular InkPad, which is 7.8 inches. Aside from the BigMe B1 Pro, which was the first e-ink device to use Kaleido 2, this is honestly the one you're going to want to look at, because the BigMe is a little bit locked down in its own ecosystem. You can't go to any URLs, whereas the Pocketbook InkPad is completely internationally friendly, and it's got a lot going for it. Right away, you notice one thing. It looks absolutely amazing compared to Kaleido 1. Kaleido 1 was a little bit gray and a little bit blue, and it just wasn't stable. This looks absolutely fantastic, and you can navigate over to the color guide that they have put front and center for you to really get a handle and an idea of how color is going to look on your unit. And it looks fantastic, everything from its little exhibition of comic books to art, textbooks, science, and of course, just overall beautiful imagery makes it seem like maybe they do have a handle on Kaleido 2 with this latest generation. The hardware itself hasn't really changed that much. You do still have the same setup down below with the USB port, SD card, and power button, and of course the 4 buttons on the bottom. You have home, more, and then left and right. You do have a dual bezel design with a black bezel and then an outer bezel surrounding that, giving a nice contrast color. In terms of e-reading, an obvious advantage of color is that you can see the cover art in full color. Once you go away from that, it does look a little bit different. Reason being, the background isn't as white as, say, a Kindle Paperwhite. Because there is still that color filter array over the entire device's screen, you do get a little bit of grayness. It is better than the first gen, but it is present. For the most part, reading a book takes no advantage of color in its inherent form. It's just black text on a white background. However, if you long press on something, that's when it gets interesting. You get 4 highlight colors. You get light blue, light purple slash pink, kind of like a lilac, light yellow, and light green. And if you press on one, like the yellow for example, it will turn yellow, and you can actually put as many colors on any part of the text, as you can see right here, as you can fill the whole thing, and it looks fantastic. And the colors are very contrasting to each other. It's not just like it's all the same hues, so it does look very good up against each other. You also get something very interesting on the later generations of Pocketbook hardware and software is scribble. Now, a lot of devices out there do not allow you to scribble on EPUB books, but with the Pocketbook, you actually can use your finger on the screen. And you do have some scribble options as well. You do have some pen styles and some colors, but we're gonna mostly keep this for the note-taking section, because you would be surprised that this does actually have color note-taking as well. Another advantage of Pocketbook devices is that they're very friendly when it comes to sideloading content. You simply drag and drop anything like this PDF to the unit's storage and it just shows up. You don't have to put it in any specific folder. You don't have to use software on your PC to drag and drop it. It is simply just drag and drop. Now, tapping on the center of the screen, you do get some options down below. And yes, again, you get that scribble. So although it's not the fastest device in the world, you can do some scribbling on there. Another beauty of a larger screen device is that it more represents the true size of manga, as you can see here from this One Piece manga. Although it is technically unnatural because typical manga isn't in color, but that's just a bonus, because to have the same quality of an actual manga but have it in color is a little bit of a treat. Now you can do some pinch and zooming. It's not the quickest on the market and it doesn't give you any sort of mini map, but it's honestly not that bad. And once you let go, it does do its render and everything kind of just renders itself and takes care of any of the ghosting. Now don't get too excited about apps. It's not apps in the traditional Android sense where you can download APK files, you can put OneDrive and all that kind of thing. You do have Dropbox Pocketbook, but that's where it ends. You don't get Google Drive or OneDrive or anything like that. But you do get something very interesting that pertains to color, and that is this. That is coloring. Coloring has a bunch of preloaded things and you can choose any of these and just start coloring. There's a bunch of different ways you can go about this. You can use the paint bucket, the pen itself, or a spray can. Using the paint bucket will just very simply color in exactly what you tap. Tap the background. Or if you use the spray can, you can go ahead and choose a color and just start spraying on the screen. Now, because you see us using a stylus here, this is simply a capacitive stylus. So once you turn it on, it just does the same thing as your finger does. This doesn't affect any other secret layer or anything like that. And you do have the pen as well. If you go to the top, you can choose your pen and just start making notes on the screen. Now this is no 10.3 inch Big Me, but this does have some note-taking capabilities. You do have a color palette right here with 8 different colors, one being black, one being white, which is just the absence of color. And because obviously there's no pressure sensitivity, you do have 5 selectable thicknesses. Moving over to the eraser, you only have regular eraser, so it erases exactly what you touch. It's not erase all, and it is not stroke eraser. You do also have the ability to put in text. You can box a certain range, start typing away, press enter, and text shows up on the screen in any color that you want. You can also go over to the text augmentation and change the font style, the font size, and you can change whether you want it bold, italicized, or both, and it will change respectively. You also have the option to undo and redo, and you can delete the entire page. If this is your first time checking in on color e-readers, color is mostly passive with an array filter laying over the screen itself. So as you can see right here, going on websites, browsing the internet on news publications doesn't make it any slower just because it's in color and you get all of the benefits. The form factor is nice, the build quality is great, it's running USB-C, and more importantly, the colors look good. This is such a relief to see that the colors look fantastic. We've seen a bunch of iterations of devices that came out last year that were just not up to snuff. The Pocketbook InkPad Color is doing it correctly. There doesn't seem to be anything in the way of your eyes and the beautiful display that is coming through on the 7.8 inch screen. Bundled with a paint-esque coloring app and a scribble app, not to mention the ability to write on even EPUBs, makes this the best color e-reader to date. If you want to grab this, it is available on our website at goodyreader.com/blog/shop, and stay tuned for more coverage on this device and many other Kaleido 2 devices on youtube.com/goodyereader, and for a full review of the InkPad Color by Pocketbook, this is Peter.